Hello everyone. Today I would like to show you an additional example of how to search for the Purple Emperor Abatura Iris in summer, because it's just such a beautiful example here. So maybe first at all something about the habitat. We can see two tracks which cross each other, and it's not completely sealed off. We have some wet parts and some parts with plants on the track. So this is really good. Abatura Iris don't like streets or tracks which are sealed off completely. And yeah, so this is very good here in this example. And also these two ways which crossed each other are perfect. We are inside of a forest, but also we can see that there's a large part where the sun can come into the forest. And so these tracks offer multiple microclimatic conditions. On the one hand, I think this is south, so we can, or we have parts where the sun can reach the ground and where we do have a very high temperature and where it's very sunny. And on the other hand, we have parts where there's a higher humidity, where it's more shady and cooler parts. So this is very important for many species which live inside of the forest and the edges of forests. So there are many, many microclimatic conditions and also many habitats for different species here in this area. And I already mentioned it in a video before, Abatura Iris prefers more shady places with a higher humidity. So this would be this part where no sun is. And here you can see a willow, a sallow. And this is really, really, really perfect, I would say. So I will show you something, because now in summer, it's really easy to find the larvae of the Purple Emperor, because they have a very distinctive feeding pattern. And you also can see a little sign I've made. So what do you have to look for? You can see it already in the video. The young larva of the Purple Emperor goes to the tip of the leaf, usually, and feeds on both sides of the leaf towards the middle. So we've got this very distinctive feeding pattern that at the end or at the tip of the leaf, there's such a little triangle. And on the top of the triangle, you can see the larva. You can see it, it's a typical emperor larva. And well, the feeding pattern is really distinctive, and you can see it from quite large distances. And also here you can see another one. You see it there. So always these leaves with this very distinctive feeding pattern from the left and right of the leaf, and at the tip of the leaf there's part left, and that's the region where the larva sits on. So it's very easy, and you can, when the tree is higher than you, you can see it even when it's in 3 or 4 meters. You still can see that there is an Abatura Iris larva in the tree. It's very easy and very distinctive, and so that's why I just wanted to show it to you, because it's very easy now to find these larvae of Abatura Iris, the Purple Emperor. Try it out, and yes, good luck with it.